Good evening. Gonna play some American Truck Sim tonight. While I'm doing that, I'm going to be streaming a friend of mine's podcast. I think I'm gonna start doing this every week. There's currently 3 episodes up right now. I think tonight we'll start with their 3rd one, which is Ghostbusters, and that's kind of relevant because the Ghostbusters movie just came out. So I think that'd be cool. We'll get the game fired up here, and I'll get this the podcast playing. Let's see here. Yeah, it's different. Share the link here that I'm playing off of. There's that. So if you don't listen to any of their old stuff, you certainly can. Let's fire up the podcast. Might have to adjust the volume. We've got that going. Let's get the game fired up here.
All right, hello and welcome back to another episode of Video Rewind Podcast.
We watch bad films so you don't have to.
I like that rendition.
I'm your host, Ryan Hickey, and with me as always is my brother.
I'm your favorite brother.
Yeah.
Patrick Hickey. I have not really watched this film in many years, but I know it pretty good.
And my computer
and
died.
Our guest with a dead compute.
Yes, is Sir Joseph B. Ziegler of House Ziegler. Yes, that is me.
We have an awesome episode for you guys today.
Should I get my charger or no?
No.
Fuck it. I feel like we're not even going to be scrolling through it anyway, since it was freezing lock and going.
But this is a special episode. We're going to release this early on Friday.
Which, if you're hearing it, you'll be hearing that we said
probably Saturday. Yeah.
So we released it today.
But this is our special Friday episode, just for the release of Ghostbusters, the reboot, remake, whatever you want to call it. Whether you love it or absolutely hate it.
Should we not speak on it? Like,
I was just going to ignore it because it makes me fucking angry. We're going to just ignore it. You can love it or hate it. Everyone's entitled to their own opinions. But we're going to just release this and do a fun episode.
Hey, home place. We're listening to a podcast from some childhood friends of mine. They kind of run through reviews of, like, old movies and stuff. It's pretty funny. I think it's entertaining. So.
Clickbait articles and the fucking arguing on Facebook and arguing with friends about
the Pokemon.
Whatever.
Enjoy.
And just watch or listen to a review about Ghostbusters 2.
Yeah.
I like the rhyme.
The film came out in 1989. It was directed by Ivan Reitman, written by Dan Aykroyd and Harold Ramis, and starring Bill Murray.
Yes.
Yes. Yes!
Ernie Hudson, Harold Ramis and Dan Aykroyd, Sigourney Weaver, and Rick Moranis. Also, Annie Potts as Janine.
That was a terrible impression.
Alright, so what was the first remembrance you have of Ghostbusters 2?
This movie, Ghostbusters 1 and 2 and the animated series and Extreme Ghostbusters are a massive part of my upbringing. Ghostbusters 2, I was born in 87, so I probably saw Ghostbusters 2 first, even though I don't remember all of it. Earliest memories is the bathtub scene with the slime coming out. Scared the shit out of me.
Really?
Oh my god. I must have been 3 or 4.
Yeah.
It was so cool until it tried to eat Dana Barrett. I fucking live and breathe Ghostbusters. You will be hard-pressed to find somebody who is a bigger fan of these films than
I am. My brother.
huge.
And
I'm
can't,
telling you, my brother
and
you go back
wanna,
and forth.
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
go.
Yeah.
We have the my brother's. I keep finishing.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah,
yeah.
But I fucking love this movie, and it's been a part of my life for as long as I can remember.
Yeah.
All right. I'm gonna start playing here in a second.
What do you mean?
Just finishing setting up here.
I still have those same pillowcases that glow in the dark.
Dirty old
Thank
boy.
You very much. Same
me,
underoos.
I was also introduced at a young age, but I don't remember watching it as much as just playing it all the time in the backyard.
Oh, yeah.
And we had
yeah.
Slimer costumes, and we would wear our Slimer
yeah,
costumes and slide down the stairs in them, and like it was just the craziest thing into
yeah.
a bunch of pillows. Running around. I was always the girl. We would play fucking Ghostbusters in the yard. I remember
yeah.
being Kylie from Extreme Ghostbusters
yeah.
because I had those little fucking disc shooters.
That was fun
all the nonetheless.
Yeah.
So what about you, Jacob?
Yeah, actually, see, I grew up in a household where my brother was obsessed, still is obsessed with Ghostbusters. So we were huge fans of watching movies. Of course, and I watched the first. Now I can't sit here and be like, oh, I remember when I was a kid. No, I just remember sitting in front, like we popping Ghostbusters, just my brother and I, like, how fun it was because I couldn't play with his toys. And the cool fucking
ghost thing.
He had a bunch of other toys. He had the
firehouse.
Yeah, but what's the actual toy where you capture the ghost?
The trap.
Yeah, the trap.
Yeah, the ghost trap.
And, yeah, we got the
ghost trap.
Yeah, we had the ghost trap.
Yeah.
We had the backpacks.
You had,
we had the slime.
I didn't have that.
I remember you had a whole
I had a whole jumpsuit and the backpack.
Yeah, my brother.
And you had the backpack. We had the slime blower and the ghost trap.
I guess
trap.
You were a Ghostbuster.
Yeah, you guys had
more.
Let me
turn
them up a little bit.
But yeah, so
I had
yeah.
so much.
I grew up with one and two. Like my brother was obsessed with it. I was like, oh, these are cool movies. These are awesome. I remember. I mean, I know we're talking about the second one, but
yeah.
the first one I always remember.
It's not
the
too
library,
loud, is it, home place?
When I rewatched the first mm-hmm. one earlier, even though we're not doing the first
Which
one, I remember.
A beautiful
right,
library. I've actually
oh my
been
gosh,
there,
really.
And it's so great to stand outside
yeah.
of that and just be like, "This is
yeah.
fucking amazing." Like,
such a
straight movie.
Such
amazing.
A fucking beautiful opening scene in the first one, but even the second one, I always just remember the crazy German doctor.
He's like the best part
yeah.
of this
He was
movie.
Great. I remember
yeah,
the
he's the counselor from Adam's family.
Yeah.
The second one. Family values or
yeah, yep. I remember when the Statue
okay.
of Liberty lady
Good.
And then the final like sequence fight scene with the what's his name? Oh, of course, in the baby.
Vigo.
On the, yeah, and the baby
Vigo
on the lights,
or the Carpathian.
Those, yeah, those were always like those are oh, and like the train. I don't know. Those are all
oh, yeah,
like those scenes that I always
yeah.
remember. But having said that, I wanted to say real quick the budget of the film. I'm sorry that I had four phones up, but papers.
You are arrested
yeah.
for treason of a podcaster.
$37 million it cost to make it, and they grossed $215 million.
Okay.
I was
yes.
gonna say
they killed it.
Well, first I want to say that I wanted to be Garrett when playing Ghostbusters, but I didn't own a wheelchair. So if you're wondering why I was Kylie, I fucking didn't own a wheelchair. I would have been Garrett all day. Because I was Slimer for the first one.
Yeah.
I mean, who do you play in the second one? Except for, you know, fucking... I would be Dan Aykroyd, easily, your bankman.
Yeah. So...
But I want to say, substantial budget, and it delivered. Everybody was thrilled when it came out.
Oh, yeah.
And it just... It created a new level of Ghostbuster foundation to build upon.
I thought the first one was brilliant.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Amazing.
I
yeah,
love
yeah.
the fucking... The second
Absolutely.
One's great. Like I
yeah.
love this because I think that whole slime. Like I like that whole even how it starts.
The river of slime.
Yeah, like that's the shit that starts like freaking people out. And then like the whole music playing it interact. I thought that shit was cool. I liked how they didn't try to do. And again, that's the problem with the 80s and late 90s and 2000 films is where when they do a sequel, they gotta triple it up from the first one. And the first one, they did so much shit in the first one, so it's like, well, how can we top the first one? Well, let's not fucking worry about having a shit ton of these fucking monsters, ghosts. Let's just do it. Let's just do another one with a good story. And
I think that's Harold Ramis for you.
Yeah.
Like, he is a brilliant writer.
Yeah.
He definitely put things into a palpable arrangement. So it was just kind of from the east of Dana Barrett walking through the sidewalk and
the
cracks.
Dan Aykroyd and Harold Ramis work perfectly together.
Ah, yeah.
Because Dan Aykroyd is a little crazy and he believes in all this stuff, aliens and
yeah.
ghosts and, I mean, anything you can think of, he believes it. And Harold Ramis was always the grounded one.
Yeah,
and, like,
the logical thing.
Yeah,
yeah,
the logical one, and kind of push back. And together they made a perfect, perfect mix. Like, the second movie might not be perfect.
It's good, though. It holds its own. Yeah,
but
yeah,
it is such a good fucking
weight.
Movie, and it's so much fun, even if the end falls flat a little bit. But it's such a good movie, and I love seeing these characters back together.
Definitely rest in peace. R.I.P., baby.
Yeah, Harold Ramis is such a great guy.
Also known for Orange County with Jack Black. Thank you for that one.
Yeah, I mean, he's done so much shit.
I think the whole cast was perfect. Bill Murray, big Bill Murray fan, baby.
The way you keep saying that, I'm thinking you're gonna go Bill, not the science guy.
This is what you do with your spare time.
All right, so I mean, who in the film is your favorite for this particular one?
That is a good question.
I think all four of them are perfect.
Shit,
I love
I forget what his name is, but the
German
museum,
guy.
Yeah, German guy. Yeah. Oh, like, and everything he does is ad-libbed, which is so
really?
Great. Because, like, one of the first times you see him, he goes up to a random extra and just goes. And he just is fucking great. He has so many great moments like that. And it's so fun.
Yeah. Look up that guy's name, all you out there, because I think that he stole the show a little bit as far as an evil villain goes, you know?
Yeah.
Vigo, he doesn't make a solid appearance until the very end.
Yeah.
So for this other character, and I'm sorry we don't know your name, and I won't even make one up in your honor, but we loved your shit, so
yeah.
Keep on rocking, bro.
Oh, but you know who I love? And he does not get enough fucking credit. He's never been on any goddamn DVD or VHS cover. Ernie Hudson playing Winston Zeddemore. He is down to earth and fucking funny and, like, just holds the team together, and, like, for whatever fucking reason, he has never been on a cover of a DVD.
Oh, really?
You go back and look, it is even a fucking
right.
shot from the first movie
yeah.
of the four of them walking up the steps
yeah.
towards Zool.
Yeah.
They cut him out.
Really?
I have no fucking idea why. Makes me so angry because I've met him more than once, and he is the nicest fucking person you will ever meet in your life. He
right.
is genuine and hilarious.
You know
yeah.
what the cool thing is, even like for the plot
the
of the movies
awesome.
And everything, I love how he came in like, I don't give a shit what the job is, I'm just gonna do it
yeah.
with you guys. And like everybody else is
yeah,
so
there's steady
shit
paycheck,
crazy.
He's just,
you know what I mean?
He's got the glare, that's it.
And that's exactly what you need, like a guy, I'm just here to fucking work.
Yeah. yeah.
Because everybody else is on their head most of the time
yeah.
spinning around. I was gonna say my personal favorite in both films, Sigourney Weaver, hands down.
Oh,
she
is
was fucking
She's
just a great, genuinely great actress. In
yeah. Well, she adds
she's
a gravity.
Powerful. A lot of
gentle. Yeah, gravity to any film she's
yeah.
in. She adds like a seriousness to
yeah.
it. That like Dana Barrett in the
yeah.
first movie. She is fucking like you believe her.
She's
like
obsessed. She's fucking going nuts.
Yeah.
With
oh my gosh, she is so good.
She's Aliens
a
2 is so cool.
Yeah.
Like in my opinion, like I liked Aliens 2. Of course, there's a lot of more action killing aliens. But she, like, everybody else was cheesy, and she was, like, this only, like, realistic, like,
yeah.
character. Like,
yeah.
She is going to be, I mean, she is one of the greatest actresses of all time.
Yeah, yeah.
Hands down. And,
talk about, like, a body of work.
That
yeah,
hot
oh,
shit.
Oh, my God.
Oh, damn body.
She knows how to make her way through films. Walking in and out of roles like a goddamn model. So... She's a total fox. I do want to say that I took the kids to see Finding Dory, and
yeah.
Sigourney Weaver made a nice little impression on that film
how
as well.
She really
so I was
fun.
Really happy.
Yeah.
Tying that in, I just think that it was so cool that they brought her for the second one with a bastard child.
Yeah,
that's
a bastard.
You know,
oh,
it was
yeah,
the mystery
well,
of this bastard
yeah.
child.
Yeah,
I always thought it was Bill Murray's kid until like...
Yeah, it's not. It's actually... It's not definite, but it was... They talk about it in Ghostbusters 2 that it's somebody's kid from the orchestra she worked in the first film. And because the only person you see is that pale guy who Bill Murray makes fun of...
Oh, that's right,
people
yeah.
assume, like, oh,
that's
the father...
Right.
But she
that's
talks about
scene. That's a great scene.
Yeah, yeah.
And here I thought it was from the second coming of Gozer.
Oh, it's always that second coming that gets you. But yeah, and they talk
we're
about
out of rubbers.
Him.
fuck it.
They talk about him. I guess he got a better job in Europe or something like that, and took it, leaving her by herself. And
Big Apple. Bill Murray, like the man he is, comes in to check up on the baby.
No, he babysits, right? That's how it happens. Yeah, I was like, who am I?
I'm Dan Aykroyd fixing the crib.
That's right.
Bill Murray babysitting.
The guys just helping out because they're all good.
Baby ends
guys.
Up on the ledge.
Yeah. Oh God, bad baby. Well, it's bad mothering, actually, because it's like she's there with the hottie.
Here.
You know when you're like, oh, well, it's something about sexism and all this? Like in the second one, I mean, you have Sigourney Weaver, who actually is like this powerful, independent woman raising her child.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
She has some guys around, and then you just have that like the sexy girl who's not really even there. Is she? Yeah, she's still technically a secretary for them, right?
Yeah.
So it's like, well, I don't know.
It's office orchestrator. The only thing I'm gonna say about this is, you see all this bullshit Sony is trying to push hard, saying that anyone who doesn't like the film is a sexist, which is absolute bullshit, because my favorite parts of the first and second movie and the series are Janine and Sigourney Weaver, because Janine is fucking strong, she's smart, she stands up against these four guys, like she stands on her own, and she's tough as nails. The second movie, she's even sexier.
Oh my
gosh, even better, hottie. And she's a fucking hottie, she's smart, and she knows what she wants and goes after it. Even though it's Rick Moranis returning as Lewis Tully.
There's the
she
man.
Goes for it.
Yeah, she's
I mean,
a big fan of the brains.
Like, I loved the toy for the animated series. She has Ghostbuster outfit and a pack. She's part of the team.
Yeah.
Just like Sigourney Weaver is basically part of the team. Like, this movie wouldn't be the same without these women.
Yeah.
And it's fucking ridiculous to ever say that Ghostbuster fans are sexist, because... Yeah.
Even though we objectify them for their sexy smoking
bodies,
I don't think
Sigourney
I just think that's another part of the appreciation, you know.
Yeah,
but I could get down with Kristen Wiig too.
I'm sorry. I really think that the whole sexist thing is.
It's fucking mind blowing that they have tried to continue this shit instead of just accepting some people are gonna like it, some people aren't. You can't remake a classic American film that is beloved by millions of people,
so many people worldwide,
and then act surprised, they're upset about it. It's gonna happen. Nobody's right, nobody's wrong, whatever, it doesn't matter, but it's fucking ridiculous. There's many reasons not to like the movie.
I was going to suggest that we see the new movie before making any rash decisions on it.
I will never see that movie.
I'm truly being open-minded about it. I hope it's my only critique of the whole the preview was the ghosts, clearly, because like they did such a great job in Ghostbusters 1 and 2 without real CGI, you know?
Yeah.
And they did fucking beautiful, brilliant special effects.
So what do you think of this? Their home place?
Yeah, but wait till it comes out. But who knows? Maybe I'm just going to wing it and just be like, I'm going to see this movie. Having said that, let's go to Ghostbusters 2.
Yeah, Ghostbusters
2. This is why we're here. Great.
Ghostbusters 2 starts off with Dana walking down the street with a baby carriage as slime pops up out of a crack in the cement. People around her are acting shitty. There's like a woman on crutches who gets knocked over by a purse snatcher and all this other crazy
shit. A man
shit.
Fighting a ticket, and it's just
like general, like showing that New York City is just a shithole.
I thought it was pretty entertaining. So there's a few other podcasts out there that they've done. And I've got the link for this current one down there in the bottom of my profile if you're interested. I think they did one on Predator, and I can't remember what the other one was.
It stops dead in the street, which makes Dana call her old friends, the Ghostbusters.
Something's wrong. Something's off. It's really weird and creepy.
Something strange in this neighborhood.
Yeah. Once you have
a neighborhood, who are you gonna call?
But I love when you see the Ghostbusters for the first time. It's only it's Winston, Dan Aykroyd, and Ernie Hudson. And they basically walk in like, where's the problem, ma'am?
Yeah.
And it just ends up being a fucking kid's birthday party. Yeah. And they just have to sing the fucking song.
That's right.
For those shitty little kids.
Oh,
and they're like, okay, there's something strange.
Yeah, I grew up with Ryan and Patrick. They're brothers. I lived down the street from them.
Ghostbuster.
And when he says he played Ghostbusters in his backyard, he really did. Like, that was something we did on a very regular basis. Yeah, they very very honest.
Is the third floor of the firehouse.
And
I didn't know that until fucking recently. Yeah. That is so badass. But we see that
their podcast
kind of down on their luck. Dan Aykroyd and Ernie Hudson.
No bullshit.
Loading up their packs, talking about, oh, what a good time they had, but they got shut down by the city. By every
Tom, Dick, and Sally.
It literally starts off, they're in shit. They're knee-deep in shitty depression, and they're at rock bottom. So it's kind of, as far as writing goes, too, I think that's really fucking cool.
Well, it's a great it's a great way to start off the movie, where they have to start at the bottom and work their way back up, just like they did in the first movie.
I also
especially for good reason, you know, because they did make a pretty decent dent in the city for the first episode.
I wanted to say, too, about, like, you have the, not to be like, oh, you have the antagonist, but the antagonist is right in the fucking first frame of the shot when the goose comes up. I think it's, I don't know, as far as story goes, I thought it was fucking brilliant. Not
well,
brilliant,
then you
I
see,
think that's a little partial, but I thought it was a really good setup.
Yeah, it was a really good setup. And you see, when you first see Bill Murray, he is the host of his own TV show,
The Dude, The Boy.
World of the Psychics.
Yeah.
and he's talking to a couple psychics who think they know when the world is going to end.
Yeah.
And there's like such a funny scene. Like Bill Murray pulls it off perfectly. With the one woman who thinks she was abducted.
Yeah. I think he did a lot of improv, or no, they expected a whole script on that. Because there's a lot of, like, even in both movies, there's a lot of times she just gets fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Especially the camera scene.
Yep.
Oh my god!
Yeah, I can't tell you how many times I've watched this movie with him. It was one of those things that we just did. It was a regular weekend thing.
They can't really,
I'd say, oh, I don't know, there's what, usually 5 weekends in a month, and I'd say 4 out of those 5 weekends involve this movie.
Like said that briefly, but that whole scene I love, because it sets up that Dan Aykroyd's kind of getting slightly possessed by his eyes.
Yeah.
But
they dig that hole.
As well as many others, like we used to watch Jurassic Park and, you know, Predator movies. I mean, we were kids, but we loved this stuff. So it's really cool that he's doing a podcast about it. Ryan, the host, he also owns a business, and he makes like Halloween masks and props and stuff like that. He's been working on a, I want to say it's a like a movie set, and he's been doing that as well, doing makeup and stuff on actors and actresses. So it's pretty cool to see, you know, a childhood friend doing well. And now I can share his podcast. I got their permission to do so, and that's why the link and stuff is in my bio. And also their the picture of their podcast
they
cover.
Take the slime back to the fucking place, and they start experimenting. So they see that it moves the music, it touches the toaster starts going insane. But
naughty toaster, bad.
I was gonna say like that.
And I may or may not get an honorable mention. I don't know yet.
That's right.
And they end up
in one of their podcasts. So we'll see. I hope this takes off for him.
Moranis basically throws him under the bus, and he's so fucking mousy.
Yeah.
And like knows jack shit about.
It basically ruins it for him, anyways.
It's amazing, but the.
I'd like to get him on a live show.
He's like, she put that dude
and do something on Twitch while we're playing a game or something. I think it'd be cool to have a in-depth conversation about, you know, movies and all the stuff we grew up doing, and I think it'd be cool.
It was such a funny scene, like the three of them.
Yeah.
And Rick Moranis are so fucking funny.
Now this I actually remember from the Ghostbusters Game Boy game. The Scapelli brothers were one of the first people you fight.
Uh-huh.
I was like, it is Scapelli. They introduced that into the Game Boy games. They have those in the new
get Ghostbuster video game that came out. I was like,
my brother's 60. Yeah, my brother can read shit out of it.
So this is one of those iconic scenes and battles that you get to relive growing up.
Well, I love that when they pop up out of the they pop up in the courtroom. It's so awesome. The special effects for them. They're clearly like guys in suits.
Yeah.
And looked fucking amazing.
Yeah.
But like it was, I love everything in Ghostbusters. How that like the ghosts are realistic but strange
and fucking
creepy. They're really fucking cool.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Every ghost is like, oh, this is the just okay. So I was gonna jump to the one. Shoot, man, I forget everybody's name. It's Aykroyd. It's
Ernie Hudson.
Yeah, Hudson. And
Harold Ramis Bill Murray.
No, Bill Murray's not in the. So they go down that old train tracks. Uh-huh. And they're like, hear that in a bad read, and all of a sudden, all those heads are on spikes.
So
I was like,
amazing.
Yo, that's, and then, Dan Aykroyd, I think it's what's his name, just staring at the face like this.
Ernie Hudson.
Yeah, it's Ernie. He's just
sitting there.
It's a quick, like, half a second shot that all of a sudden, he just literally looking at from a side shot. But yeah, but then, like, again, it's like, did you hear that? It sounds like a train. Literally, this train has been outdated for like 100 and something.
Yeah, they're walking
accident.
Along.
Yeah.
I love that they're wearing those yellow slippers and everything.
Yeah.
Oh, this has been an abandoned rail since accident in 1923.
And then there comes the fucking rail. And then the ones who are like, oh, they just stand
it as the train is going right through them. It's so fucking cool.
Great. The other two dive and just freeze.
They dive and they're like, did you?
Straight
you didn't happen to catch the number on that train? Sorry, I must have missed it.
Is that the first time that they realized the negative effects of this slime? Is that
when they were dipped in, and then they stop? That's like a subtle plot point too. Like he keeps messing with it until they
hit him,
and then they realize, oh, the music fucks with it, and you're paying on stuff.
Why he stopped in the middle of the road?
And Ray Stantz are doing all these great tests with it, with the toaster, like you were saying.
And I do love that, like, because of that, that it's like they're painting it inside the Statue of Liberty. I just like how both films, they had some massive, monster-like creature, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then, like, that was the state stuff. What the hell, marshmallow?
State puff marshmallow.
Thank you. That was the first one. The second one was the Statue of Liberty walking through. Wake me up! Wait, what the hell's this song? They even mentioned that, and the mayor's like, oh, Mayor, it's good to see you again. He's like, what the hell are you guys? What are you doing wearing pajamas? He's like, what do you mean?
What do you want me to just get on TV, tell everyone to be nice to each other?
Yeah.
This is New York.
Yeah,
it's everyone's God-given right to be terrible to each other.
That's right. Can I say one of my favorite parts?
Oh, absolutely. All right,
so like Rick Moranis, he freaking, when he's like, he's in his Ghostbusters uniform, he's trying to make it to the scene because he's left behind, and he pulls up on the bus, he's like, oh, you again, it's the green slime, what the hell is his name?
Slimer.
Yeah, Slimer. He's like, oh, all right, he's like, yeah, come on in, basically say, get on the bus.
He's like, I didn't know you had your driver's license, but okay.
Yeah, he's like, all right, don't do anything something. I forget what he says, but it's so fucking
golden.
It's just like this quick cameo.
The two oddball characters from the
film. Yeah, exactly.
Well,
yeah,
I love seeing him. He's got the earmuffs on in the full Ghostbuster outfit. And like the doors open up, and you just see him run out.
Yeah.
What an awesome guy! Could you imagine if he was your father?
Yeah,
oh, be amazing.
Actually, it was kind of sad. He stopped making movies because his wife got cancer.
Yeah, his wife got cancer.
They're talking about Rick Moranis.
Yeah.
He basically, not officially, but he basically retired.
Yeah.
And became a full-time father.
Yeah.
He still does voiceover stuff.
Okay. See, I didn't know that. I thought that was touching. But he stopped.
Yeah, really
he stopped when she got cancer, right? And then after,
yeah,
and then
he took care of her, and then eventually he just.
Gosh, what a great guy!
Yeah,
maybe when the kids are out of the nest.
And also,
because
he was awesome, man.
With the new movie, which we're not going to really talk about, he's the only original actor who turned him down and said, "Fuck it, or I don't care how much money they give me."
Yeah,
I'm not going to just do some dumb cameo.
Yeah.
That would disrespect the original fans, which was
amazing.
Cool. I think that's cool. Guy's got a lot. He's got a lot of integrity and principles
Bill
and integrity.
Dan and Howard.
Integrity.
No, wait, Harold.
Harold. I don't know why
he's
Bill.
He's not going to be in the movie. Really.
It's Ghostbusters.
Rest in peace.
He's going to be in the movie.
Do a CGI version.
Dude, that would be crazy.
How disrespectful.
That would not be right, man.
Jesus.
It'd be cool if he was alive though, and he did like a can. I don't know why the hell they tried to cancel him the fuck out. Like, why did they just have his fucking approval? I mean, because that was the biggest thing. Like, my brother always talked about it. After the second one came out, for so long they talked about a third Ghostbusters.
For like 25 years, when the internet was created, first thing I searched was Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
Ghostbusters car.
So
Ghostbusters and I found like, oh, Dan Aykroyd wants to make a sequel.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh my god. So since the beginning of the internet, I've been waiting and waiting and waiting for a fucking sequel.
Yeah.
Good point to bring up. Brian bought a hearse.
Oh, yeah.
To fucking turn it into a Ghostbusters
car.
Yeah,
that's how much I love Ghostbusters. Yeah. I'm like, oh.
Yeah. We're going to have an Ecto-1 for this podcast.
Yeah, that happened.
But when the 360 game came out, though, like the game, I remember that's when they were talking, like, yeah, I'm pretty sure they're going to make a new one coming soon with all four originals. And IMDb, I'm pretty sure, had the whole, like, they were going to...
They did,
And then I guess they just decided to do women and sex. It's
But,
there's nothing wrong with women, you just got to make
Dan
a good
Aykroyd has said...
I love women.
Dan Aykroyd has said basically the game is the official third movie. Because that game takes place in, I think it's 3 years after the second movie. Okay. So it's like 19...
That is a good way to look at it.
1993 or something.
My brother was
obsessed with that game. He beat on like all the difficulties, got all the achievements, I'm pretty damn sure.
Yeah, and like
he was obsessed. He's obsessed with Ghostbusters.
Yeah, that's such a fun game.
Yeah.
Oh. I used to, when I bought that, I played PlayStation because I'm cool. But I had a big screen TV and I had a computer chair and I would wheel myself up to the TV so all I could see was the TV and I just put on the big headphones. And I would just play. So all I could see is TV.
All you see and hear is Ghostbusters.
Yeah, and people would scare the shit out of me because, like, my girlfriend at the time would come home and be like, yeah, but what are you doing? I was in the library and there was laughing children and bloody handprints. Why would you scare me like that?
Yeah, that's
such a good fucking game.
I know. Actually, I was wondering if I could fix my Xbox because I had it downloaded. Mine's a little out of condition at the moment.
Yeah. It's disappointing. But this is the part of the movie where basically the Ghostbusters are back in action. And this is, when I was little, this is what I remembered about Ghostbusters. Like, I kind of mixed up Ghostbusters 1 and 2, where there's always that point where ghosts just start running wild. Like, the slime starts coming up through the streets and everything. And, like, I love... the woman coming in like with the big fucking stupid
the
white fur coat and she and walks through the slime and then the ferrets or whatever it's made out they pop up and start trying to attack her and she throws off the coat and things just fucking scampers away.
This old rich bitch
there's so much cool shit like that and like that whole segment is like one of my favorite parts of this movie.
Cause it's just like it was just like that the first one when all of them get out in the city because the reactor explodes or whatever and they free all the
it's so awesome.
Dude, the first one and the second one was great, but the first one was amazing. Yeah. So good. Same with the second one.
So much fun. And like the one thing that I understand, like some people think it's a downfall, but the in between the first one and the second one, the animated series came out. That's why Janine now has like red hair. She looks like a character from the cartoon.
Yeah.
Like Slimer's in it again. Like stuff like that. It's a little more fun.
Slimer's fucking great when he's in the first one, but fucking priceless. Even the second one,
I love that he's driving a bus for no fucking reason.
Exactly.
Like, people think that's kind of like a downfall, that they kind of push it more like kid-friendly and change some things around a little bit to more fit the show. But I love it. Like, I grew up watching the show, so of course I fucking love it.
You gotta get them on Ghostbusters early.
But it's fun. I mean, it still has all the things that make Ghostbusters great. All of this, just everything about it, still the Ghostbusters in the same universe, the same fun stuff. It's such a good fun.
I'm dropping a patent right now for a Ghostbusters cell phone game where you can go out and catch real ghosts in the street.
That's fucking
Ghostbusters
dope.
Ghostbusters
that would be so
awesome. That would be so fun.
Well, they do all those other means of like these darker games and like if this game was going, you see a kid running from like a demonic creature.
I did see one for like a Call of Duty style shooter, and they meet up and they have like these shootouts in parks. I think that would be totally cool.
You're gonna see so many effing games like that.
I hope so. Because that is a wave of the future.
Nintendo stock, because I know I play the stock. I don't do the stock. Went up like 24 points just when that game came out. So if you would have just like thrown money in Nintendo stock, I remember they were going to... All right, I'm not talking about Pokemon. Screw that. Let's get back to Ghostbusters.
All right. At this point, Venkman and Dana are on their nice little date, I guess. And the guys end up falling into the river of slime. And when they crawl out, they're fighting with each other. They're slinging slime
all around.
Yeah, they're pushing each other and arguing. And then suddenly, it's a little goofy, but like they realize, like, oh, it's the negative slime. Take off your clothes. Yeah. Take off all your clothes.
That's right.
And then take off all your clothes. It's funny because
what's up, Lizard? How are you?
Slime, but I mean it's kind of like
currently listening to a podcast.
But they show up at the nice restaurant.
That's right, yep.
Like,
that's where Bill Murray is.
Yeah.
We got it all.
They're talking about Ghostbusters 2, the movie.
That was so funny. And that's where they had that scene with the mayor again.
If you want to know more information, there's a link in my bio.
Like they're crazy.
It's called Video Rewind Podcast.
Like, well, I'm not with these guys.
That's what he says. I'm not,
well, I was going to say the bathtub scene.
That's such a cool scene.
I forget where that takes place.
Oh man, it's her
apartment.
Oh yeah,
Oscar ready, taking off his diaper and all that stuff to give him a bath, and the water starts turning to slime.
Yeah.
And then eventually the bathtub tries to eat her.
That's right.
And that's when she ends up leaving, and she shows up at Venkman's.
That's right. And he stays
his apartment and ends up staying
there. That's right.
Yeah, and like kind of rekindles their relationship.
Yeah,
and then
they keep going in there. That's how they test.
How's it going?
Yeah,
haven't seen you for a while.
I love this scene where, you know, they took those photos at the museum.
Yeah, but yeah, I think that painting is fucking beautiful too.
Oh yeah,
I mean,
it's
like
so
they
cool.
paint they paint that to the fucking movie. That
yeah,
was,
I may have to paint
Vigo the
car. Yeah, seriously.
Yeah, the guy who plays Vigo, he was this crazy Russian wrestler. But he came to America and he. Basically, he's an actor. He was in Die Hard. He's one of the henchmen.
Is it the Die Hard one? Or I thought it was the
Die
Vengeance.
Hard 1,
oh, okay.
Yeah, he's in Die Hard 1.
Oh, I know who you're talking about.
Yeah,
now, yeah.
And I think he's like in it for a little bit, but he gets fucking blown up or whatever.
Do you met him at the Comic Cons and like the fuck or the movies?
I met Winston.
Winston.
He was fucking awesome.
All right. So basically, after her baby is kidnapped. Dana Barrett takes the drunk bus to the museum.
Give
me back my baby.
I love it. You know, after the Ghostbusters, the Ghostbusters are taken away. They're with the mayor, and the mayor's dickhead assistant has them condemned.
Dickhead. Sorry, go ahead.
Nothing but a dickhead.
Dickhead. All right, go.
We didn't really talk about too much, but just Janine. Like relentlessly hitting on Lewis Tully and brings him.
Yeah, I really haven't played this online.
Just
been doing
up,
single player
because,
like, I do stuff like this. I've got
the
podcast playing
Lewis
in the background.
Yeah.
I'll probably stop the cast then, and then I'll be hosting Crown the Beast. So.
And the weird German guy. I don't know why he's in that weird, like, Mary Poppins outfit with a character.
He's probably possessed. Yeah,
if you're going after a child, you want to
look like a child rapist.
Yeah,
you gotta look child molested. Like
so if you're gonna go after a child, you want to dress up like Pikachu.
Yeah.
But of
get in the Pokeball, little baby.
And then he's trying to kidnap the baby because Vigo, I guess he wants a new body for the new century.
Yeah.
And he wants Dana to be the mother of the coming of. Whatever.
Vigo.
So when it takes the baby, she automatically just runs to her baby. She fell into the trap.
Yeah, she knows.
She rides her bike over to
She falls in the trap.
I'm here. Where's my baby?
Bitch.
Yeah.
But this is another great sequence where Cheech is a dock worker. Do you guys remember this?
Yeah, Cheech makes
they have all these, like, all these stuff happens. All the ghosts are going crazy.
It's like the goose coming from the sewer.
Yeah, and one of the best jokes is Cheech. And another dock worker. Somebody says that the Titanic arrived.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I totally,
and
that's
a shot
right.
of Cheech Marin, like, better late than never.
Yeah, that's right. I forgot about that scene, man. I forgot the Titanic.
But that's great. And it's so awesome. You see all the, like, there's like
the
line
the dead
people,
are coming
like,
out.
Dead,
yeah,
like,
the dead are
walking
out of
the,
yeah, that was awesome.
Great
that was cool.
That's a barometer for madness.
Yeah. And shockingly, this is a foreshadow for James Cameron's inspiration of Titanic. He saw that. He's like, I gotta make a movie.
Stole that scene.
Yeah, 100%. He had to go visit the actual grave of the Titanic, finds it, and then he makes a movie.
Yeah, bastard.
So, very true.
But they suit up and they get ready to bust some heads.
Yeah.
And that's when the museum is just covered in bubble gum. Well, that
big
pink
old bubble gum bubble.
And watched this recently, like trying to figure out. Some people don't like this movie. Like some people absolutely hate this movie, which I don't understand because it's fucking awesome and it's fun. But I think this is kind of where the movie goes off the rails a little bit because they show up and they can't penetrate
the pink
slime.
The pink cum, yeah.
Yeah. I think
this
is where
I don't see how does it fall flat because that is epic as shit.
But that's the problem.
I think awesome.
That is an awesome scene.
Yeah.
They're like ready
that's
to go.
Fun, yeah.
They're there ready to battle. Yeah. And then they're like, oh, fuck, that didn't work. Back to the drawing board and they drive all the way to the Empire State.
Hey, here comes the Empire State Building.
Yeah.
But they go all the way back to the Statue of Liberty. They make it out. How the fuck they got there in the middle of the night. But whatever, it doesn't matter.
How the fuck
they
got there.
That's the thing for me, though.
It's
beyond me. You can't have them rush in, defeat the bad guy.
Yeah. They had to
have
some
the girl, save the baby, roll credits.
It's got
to
be
another level.
Yeah.
And to actually animate the Statue of Liberty, that's an epic.
Well,
dude, that's great stuff.
I like that. Just the editing of that. I don't know what it is. Like, it's just like this lull where. I mean, I wish they kind of just went straight for the Statue of Liberty. Because I do love the visual. They have that giant Nintendo pad. And you can see it's a woman in, like, this costume. And, like, a miniature set and everything. And she's just crushing police cars. I love,
like, the
shots of that.
It's funny because it looks like a normal police car. And then when it steps on it, it's like, oh, you can tell it's a shit. But still, it's such a fucking great job that they did with what they had.
I'm trying to think of how many actual pieces of media show the Statue of Liberty as a living, breathing creature, character. And the one that comes to mind is, I'm just a bill, just a stupid old bill, trying to get up on that motherfucking pussy.
Quote, unquote, that's the exact lyrics of that song.
Yeah, referring to Clinton, of course, the administration that changed America.
Oh, man,
yeah, but I really do love that part. I love even though it makes no fucking sense, spraying slime in there and playing insert whatever that song is.
Oh, yeah.
Every time I hear that song, I think of this movie.
Yeah.
I mean, years
Death
later,
to Smoochie.
Death to Smoochie ends with that song, and I can only think of Ghostbusters 2. But it makes no sense that would work in any possible way. But I honestly think that if they figured out a way to do it without having that lull, because there's like a 10-minute thing where they're setting all this up, and then they're like slowly walking across the bay.
Yeah.
Can you have her walk on her tippy toes?
They had stuff to set up with Dana without, maybe because
they do cut back and forth. Yeah.
And in the drawing room, you have, I was going to say Bela Lugosi. What the fuck is that short geek's name?
Ed Wood.
I love you.
Yeah.
So
Ed Wood is, I feel like, a cult classic.
Pull the strings. Pull the strings.
We should do Ed Wood for
we
one
should.
Of those. That's like a cult classic that Tim Burton that people don't know that.
Rick Moranis is coming in, right? And you have
I do love that.
Dana
That's
Barrett.
So much fun.
So, I mean, there's all these elements coming together that you have time. So it's kind of nice to have a cutaway of what the fuck they're doing.
Yeah.
They're just kind of puddling through. But I thought that was a great idea. And then the Statue of Liberty busting through and they repel down on the fucking
Yeah, that's
like
really
SWAT.
Yeah. It's just funny that they walked that thing all the way up there just to have her like lift her torch.
Yeah.
Whang!
Well, obviously the mood of the
no,
arena
know.
Changed.
Yeah.
It was an essential point.
Yeah.
So now we're in the whole...
We're at the end.
Yeah.
They're in the museum. Dana Barrett is being...
The German guy's peeing on her while Vigo is shitting on her chest.
Yeah.
You
want to
feed my mother?
That's the only...
Smell this shit. Smell it.
That's probably why they could sign on to do the third one. You know, that's
terrible.
Oh,
God. What were you eating?
But we're in the museum at the end. Dana Barrett has been captured. The baby is... up on the altar, and a crazy German guy
comes out panting.
Yeah,
this was a cool effect too because I like that it was just him in his costume, and he's walking across with a habit in
like a weird blur
fade. Yeah, like kind of
it's
kind of
cool.
It's
it's like three, yeah, three, and it comes into one.
Like an acid trip, and yeah. I hate to keep bringing this up. That was a nice effect where it goes.
But he's trying to take over the baby's body as the Ghostbusters roll up with their slime packs and their proton packs. Yeah. And
all the type of packs try to take down this big bad guy.
Cigarette packs.
Yeah.
Actually, I think they don't even smoke in this one. They smoke endlessly in the first one, but
that's
they don't smoke
call.
In the second.
Okay, now this is a good point before we close out on the ending here. Ghostbusters, the original. I want to tell you guys at home listening, if you ever want to get your dick sucked, bring a girl over and say, we're going to watch a fucking awesome movie. And you put Ghostbusters on. Something about the movie, she'll start sucking your dick 3/4 of the way through. She does not want to finish watching it. She would rather suck your dick. This goes for
no
anyone.
Woman wants
her dick. Yeah. I'm telling you.
Right.
Has never
failed.
Not worked.
Yeah.
This is why Ryan watches it so much.
Yeah.
Fucking, I walked in on him watching Ghostbusters by himself, sucking his own dick.
It's pretty damn good.
It's painful, but it feels so good.
It's so worth it, though. But I think this movie is more of a family-friendly version. The first one definitely had a lot more adult content.
Got me into smoking.
You have sex. You have sex, you have smoking. You have, there's Dan Aykroyd getting a blowjob.
Is he really?
Yeah,
I don't
ghost,
remember that.
Ghost
oh, yeah, that's right.
One.
I totally
yeah.
forgot about
fucking
that.
Fucking A. So, I mean, yeah, the second one was just more of a lighthearted, feel-good film. And
yeah, but it still has all the elements that the original Ghostbusters had.
Yeah.
I think the only... I was going to say, the one thing that really annoyed me about the end, I mean, I think it's a little bit of a lackluster ending, like I said. Like, just, I don't know, it could have been done better. But up to that point, it's amazing. But the one thing that fucking annoyed me for years was Louis Tully is outside with his goofy, big earmuffs on, and he's shooting the slime just by himself as the Ghostbusters are kicking ass inside.
That is true, yeah.
And, like, people start, like, patting him on the back and everything, like, cheering him on. I'm like, he's not fucking doing anything. At least he's not... He is literally just taking credit for the Ghostbusters.
Yeah.
And it used to drive me crazy. I didn't realize it's supposed to be, like, funny or dumb.
Yeah.
Well, the cool thing I think about that is, like, he is the mascot outside to what Ghostbusters are inside. So at least they have a face to put...
Yeah, I get that.
Yeah,
company.
Yeah,
you know, they still know who's fucking... doing the light work.
Yeah.
Even though they think it's just one goon, they appreciate that one guy saved the day.
Yeah.
It's more like everyone's drunk, like, let's go to the pink bubble.
Oh, yeah, it is
she let nature take its course.
Yeah. So she's like,
I love that. That's a one defining thing for me. At least everyone knows that the Ghostbusters fixed whatever was going on.
Yeah. What I actually thought was great too is when they first start shooting shit out of him and then he just zaps all the fucking shit back to him. So this is like the final
battle. He sends them flying.
And then Bill Murray starts mouthing off, talking to shit like.
the second one I would leave well enough alone. I thought that for the kids to be introduced to,
they slime Vigo.
That's right.
And the positive energy,
yeah,
all
that's
the
right.
people singing outside.
Yeah, that's right. I totally agree. Well, that's a little gaily corny.
It's a
feel good film.
Yeah,
it
is. They appeal to more, like you said, it's more like childlike.
I really think that's the only part that isn't
still
perfect,
great.
But
it,
the rest of the movie, I mean, 90% of this movie is so fucking fun.
Oh my gosh, yeah.
Would you guys recommend this movie?
Oh, hell yeah.
Yeah.
I would recommend, I'd say you have to see the first one, then you have to see the second one.
Yeah.
I would do back-to-back movies right away. I think those movies are the shit.
Oh, yeah.
I would say watch the second one more than you would watch the first one, because save that first one for when you want a blowjob. You don't want to wear out the magic.
Yeah.
You don't want to wear out the magic.
And if you like Ghostbusters, I would absolutely recommend Ghostbusters 2.
Yeah.
It isn't as good, but you can't beat
good.
The original Ghostbusters.
No.
It is probably one of the best films ever made. But I would definitely recommend this. It's fun to watch.
Yeah.
It has its flaws. It has things I would change about it. But it is so much fucking fun.
It's a damn good sequel.
The special effects in it are so good. Like, I love the Statue of Liberty.
Yeah.
The shots of her are so convincing. The miniatures look so great.
You think the
ghosts look amazing. Like, I think I actually like the ghosts in the second one more than the first one. Like I said, the mink coat that comes alive and all this other shit. it's just a lot of fun.
It's great visuals. So original. That's the whole aspect. Like, that's what makes the movie great too. Both films, they're both fucking original. They're funny. Bill Murray's the dude, and the rest of the cast is great. Yeah. Like, Bill Murray doesn't
everything
carry the whole
except
movie.
The name, yeah. Which they stole from the other fucking show.
Yeah.
But I think it was a fun adventure.
Wasn't
the original working title Ghost Smasher?
Yeah.
Ghost Smashers?
Yeah. That would have been good.
And then Harold Ramis actually switched it back to Ghostbusters.
That's good.
Or switched it to Ghostbusters.
Rest in peace, R.I.P.
I think it's cool, like, you took somebody else's name, but you totally made a big mark.
Yeah.
More than anything else could.
No, definitely.
I think this is a fun adventure in the same universe, the same characters, and it's, you know, what you love about the first movie.
Yeah.
Just done over again.
We're coming to you from our secret, undisclosed location. Yes. Our podcast.
Zibanka.
Thank you guys for hanging with us today. Please remember to like and subscribe, to follow, to share. But we can't thank you.
All those fun things. Yeah, we...
If you hate it, keep it to yourself.
Yeah, keep your goddamn mouth shut. We don't need your kind of opinions here.
Thank you, Ryan.
Your negativity.
Because we'll sick our vicious dog.
Bring it on.
Yeah, that dog's vicious, baby. Bite your ankle.
Who's my junkyard dog?
Leave a 5-star review on iTunes. It helps us out a lot. And put some of your favorite movies that you'd like to hear us cover in the review, and we'll add them to our list. Hopefully, we'll do a couple episodes.
Yeah, we 100% will do that.
Absolutely.
Try to shock us and throw a curveball when we don't know the
movie. Yeah, we'd love to hear.
We have three people with a vast knowledge of the movie, so.
Some stuff we haven't seen, or, you know, some rarer things. Hopefully, we'll be getting into those soon.
Yeah.
More horror and exploitation coming up very soon.
Soon.
Have a great weekend.
All right, thank you guys. See ya.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you. Goodbye.
We will see you next time on the Video Rewind Podcast
in our disclosed bunker.
We watch films so you don't have to. Send your dick pics to my brother.
Yeah. I don't know if I want that. I mean, I appreciate nude photos, but those are not my kind of variety.
Tuck it.
Tuck it. That's his favorite.
That's good.
Rewind
Buffalo
podcast.
Bill it. Buffalo Bill it.
What you want me?
Dude, how about that one? How about that meme where goes, it's a picture of Buffalo Bill. I have Pokemon in the basement. Dude, it's such a... I was screaming at that meme. Anyway.
Oh, word.
Yeah. He's like, there's Pokemon in my basement. Come on downstairs. Yeah, it's fucking good. Anyways.
Also, I want to say thank you again to Matt McClanahan
and
Corey Pace, the geniuses behind Rotak, they provided our theme song, which will lead us out now.
That's R-O-W-T-A-C, Rotak.
Have a great weekend.
All right, thank you guys. See you.
Thank you. Thank you. Goodbye.
We will see you next time on the Video Rewind Podcast
in our disclosed bunker.
We watch films so you don't have to.
So their podcast usually comes out on Monday. I was actually talking to Ryan about that today, and he said he usually puts them up Monday. They did a special one for the Ghostbusters. But what did you think, Home Place? Overall... Yeah, I was thinking so too. Well, good. I'm glad I'm not the only one who likes it. Yeah, I've heard it somewhere too, and I was trying to place where I heard it. Good catch on that too. I'll bring that up to him. There might be some copyright stuff there. That's a good catch. I'll throw it at him and see. If he can find anything on it.
We watch bad films.
Fuck me! Alright.
Oh shit. Oh Christ and fuck me. Okay.
Alright. 3, 2, 1.
I can finally do that because I have a hairy chest.
Now blow it your way. You can receive my chest stuff. I was so disappointed when I was like a teenager. I wanted, since I was like 13, I'm like, I'm going to get this big ass eagle on my chest. And then I was like, okay, I'm starting to get.
Yeah, just the two of them are brothers, Ryan and Patrick. There was a third guy there, and I don't know him. I'm thinking it might be someone they met after I had moved to Montana, obviously. So yeah, I'll have to run that by him.
Good films.
But yeah, they're
okay.
They're
no, I was gonna
brothers
say
and best friends, so,
film, so
which is cool.
So we recommend you that fucking.
We watched you mention editing that in. We watch good films.
Well, I'll
so
look into that.
Oh, what the fuck?
Gonna
so
save
gonna
this
say,
and
what we can do is just do
gonna send a host over to Crom.
So you don't have to. Just we watch films, so you don't have to. And then just put them in the book.
We watch good films, so watch them.
So we'll have them as
so
just
watch
like
them
reference.
Also.
Yeah. All right. All right. Do films first. All
right. 3, 2, 1.
But thanks for listening to them. And like I said, if you're interested in checking it out, any of their other stuff, here is a link. But it's Crom time. I think he's playing Kenshi tonight. Here we go. Catch you later.